Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'm joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is our episode 134, Merge Products and Subproducts. All right, today's question sent in from YouTube. Wants to know if from this table of products and subproducts, if we can first get the product name with nothing and then product name with additional text 1 through 6. So kind of like this, we have this list of products. Each product appears once without the subproducts and then a list of all the subproducts and go again. All right, so I toyed with a formula that would do this, but as I started to think about the formula, I said, you know, VBA is the way to go. So Alt F11, insert module, and I create a little sub here called Unwind. Now, one thing I did is wherever the active cell is when we start, that's going to be the first product. So you have to put that, select the first product, and remember that row. We're going to start to unwind things into that row. And you see as I go, I keep adding one. Next row equals next row plus one. That's how I know where to write the next value, because, you know, obviously they're not going to line up. We're going to have 7 rows for every row in the original table. So I loop for I equals active cell dot row to final row. How do I figure out the final row? Well, I press control down arrow from the active cell. And so for every row, first thing we do, go to the next row column. Actually, that should be column 9, column I. And the value there is the cell from row I, comma 1, column A. And we don't concatenate anything after it. Then go from column 2 to 7. And for each one, we're putting the value from column 1, that's column A hyphen in quotes, and then the value from column J, that'll be column 2 through 7. All right, so here's our Excel spreadsheet. We'll come back here, we'll press the run button. Wow, that's just that fast. Problem solved. There we go. All right, Mike, what do you have?
Hey, thanks, Mr. Excel. You know, VBA wins this one. There's just no way around it. Type that out. The formula I have, I'm not even sure if it's a very efficient formula, but, you know, I'll take the VBA over this any day. Now, anytime you try to unwind a data set, we want to, with formulas, we're going to look for patterns. Now, here's the pattern. We have geofan and then this kin light. It looks like we have to repeat it 7 times. So if we're looking it up, we're going to need the number in our like index to look this up. It's going to look up through this range. We're going to need relative position 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 7 times, and then 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. So we're going to have to somehow in a formula generate that pattern of numbers. And then for the subproducts, we're going to need, we'll use index, and that's a two-way lookup. We're going to need the row numbers. Well, we'll already get the row numbers from generating the ones and then the two relative positions from that first bit. But then we're going to need the column number, which will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're going to need to repeat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm actually going to hide these columns here. Right-click Hide. So I have some room here. The inside of most number incrementing formula starts with the rows I'm sitting in. I'm actually going to build it from the point of view of I4. So I'm going to say I dollar sign 4 colon I4. The 4 is locked in the first reference, but not the second one. That'll be expandable range. So I copy this down. That just gives me 1, 2, 3 to 14. I have it all highlighted, so now I'm going to hit F2. We're going to have to start with 0 for a bunch of our formulas, so I'm going to subtract 1. This will give me 0 to 13. Now, for the 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 repeating, if we divide all of this by 7, let's see what this gives us. So in parentheses, I'm going to divide this by 7, Control Enter. Well, now we have an interesting pattern. If we were used the int function, int gives us the integer part always going down. So these all be 0, and these would all be 1. So I'm going to F2 and put int around this, the int for integer. Control Enter, escape, escape. I forgot a parenthesis there. Right. So now that's not quite what we want. We want 1s and then 2s, so we add 1 back in. Oops, I hit the, the F1 key. So I'm going to hit F2 and plus 1. All right, so that'll work for that first part. Now, we're going to use this same rows minus 1. But now, instead of using the int, we're going to put it inside the mod. Now, the mod gives us the remainder. So this will give us 0 to 13. But if we divide it by 7, that'll give us the remainder. 0 divided by 7, the remainder is 0. 1 divided by 7, the remainder is 1. So we get a pattern always like 0 to 6, 0 to 6. Now, this little bit right here, we're actually going to use in our if logical test. And so we'll leave that there as one of the little formula bits. This is not quite what we want, because we want 1 to 7. So we simply add 1 back in. So now, oh, this is going to get nasty. I'm sure there's a better way to do this. Well, the first part, let's go ahead and copy these. I'm going to copy this. Control CC to open up the clipboard. Clear all. I'll Control C. And then I'll Control C here. That's the plus 1. And I'll Control C. This will be for one of the logical tests we run. For the logical test, 0 will be interpreted as false. All of the non-zero numbers would be interpreted as true. All right, so let's do our first bit. That's the index. Now, index, I'm going to look up everything under the products, F4, comma, and the row number will be that 1111, 22222, et cetera. So Control Enter, and I can copy this down. Actually, let's see. I'm going to Control C. And I don't know where the last cell is. So I'm going to scroll down, hold Shift, and click, and then Control V. So I've copied that all the way down. Now I can just double click. All right, so the next bit is we're going to have to join and do our two-way lookup. So I'm going to go ahead and actually insert another column and do that in a separate equals index. And we're going to do the whole two-way. Notice the columns are hidden, but they're still as part of our formula. Control Shift down arrow, F4. And now I need a row number. Well, the row number will be that little bit, comma, and the column number will be that little bit. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, Control Enter and double click and send it down. See, we get a reference error there. And F2, you know what? We don't have 7 columns. We have 6 columns. So for this column, I'm going to get rid of the plus 1. Control it. Now, that value doesn't matter. That's generated because we are, in essence, using this little bit right here. But that's the place where we're not going to use the second part. So that'll be OK. Now, I'm going to take this, copy. Come to the end here, and I'm going to join it. And I'm going to say if. And I want this little bit right here. This is going to give me 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. So the 0 will be the false, the value if false. And that's when we're going to put nothing. But the value if true is going to be, well, we need a dash, right? So I'm going to in double quotes space dash space, end double quote, ampersand, and join it to, whoops. I'll use my clipboard over here. I'm going to join it to that. Please get the subproduct. All right, now here's the screen tip. And I'm already confused right here. These screen tips come to the rescue. I'm going to type a comma. And then the value of false is double quote, double quote. That's so up here when it finds the 0, it'll put nothing. And we get that just the product. All right, close parentheses. I'm crossing my fingers. Control Enter. This is just insane. Double click and send it down. And it looks like that is working. Insert this to keep it clean. And it looks like it is working. Now you can see why we're giving the point to Mr. Excel for VBA. All right, we'll see you next trick.
Hey, all right, Mike, that's, you know, when I started to do the formulas the other day, I figured it was going to be int divided by 7 and then mod over here. It just wasn't coming together for me, and that's why I switched over to VBA. But that's good. I understand it now that you put it all together. So good method there, especially if you don't want to use VBA. Well, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.